dad's home. Billy's dad is a fudge packer at the local candy factory.
Live in the MCG studios, located in the undershaft of Florida, but popular in Ghana. Welcome to the Potluck Podcast. So come join us and have some fun.
Well, hello, 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 and welcome to the Potluck Podcast right here on the Podbean platform. Tonight, we are live broadcasting and having a good time, and I'm Grabo. I'm here with you, and as you may know, for those of you listening to us for the first time, we play all kinds of games, have a bunch of fun, listen to some tunes, talk about current events, as well as some historical stuff, and as well as getting things off of our chest, because, you know, the guys that we do this every week, and it's kind of therapy for us. And tonight's show is no different. And tonight just happens to be Wednesday, September 13th, the 256th day in our Gregorian calendar. And on this day in history, in 1814, Francis Scott Key was inspired to write the Star Spangled Banner after Fort McHenry successfully withstood a British attack. And that happened today in history. In 1971, a revolt in New York's Attica Correctional Facility ended in a bloody state police assault in the prison, which 29 inmates and 10 hostages were killed. As I play Dog Day Afternoon, there you go. Some Al Pacino for you. In 1985, the sitcom The Golden Girls debuted on American television, known for its focus on older women and for tackling timely topics. The series became hugely popular. As we all know, Betty White, Rue McClanahan, Beatrice Arthur, and Estelle Getty all made history today in 1985. Another show that debuted, one of the longest running primetime television shows of all time, Law and Order, debuted. Yes, that happened in 1990. In 1994, the acting commissioner of baseball announced that the remainder of the 1994 Major League Baseball season, including the World Series, would be canceled because the owners and players failed to reach a settlement during the strike that had begun in August of that year. In 2009, Patrick Swayze had passed away, and in 2015, American basketball player Moses Malone, who played with the 76ers, passed away. Famous birthdays today. We have Milton Hershey. Yes, the founder of course, Hershey Chocolate, and, of course, the Milton Hershey School, where my grandfather went. Amy Winehouse would have had a birthday today. American rapper Nas had a birthday today, as well as Tyler Perry, and former Russian president Dmitry Medvedev would have had a birthday today. Also, British author and Charlie and the Chocolate Factory writer Roald Dahl would have had a birthday today. That's coincidental, I believe, that he was born the same day as Milton Hershey and wrote about the chocolate factory. I don't know. You never know. Fiona Apple also has a birthday today. Happy birthday, Fiona. As well as adult film stars Dirk Kaber, Brooklyn Knight Divine, Monique Woods, Shawnee Reed, Katrina Reed, as well as Katerina Petrov, and of course, Hannah Hayes. Those are our birthdays for today. Also, today's holidays. Yes, there are holidays happening right here and right now. You might have but you may think that July 4th would be Uncle Sam's birthday, but today is actually the holiday where people celebrate one of the most famous icons in America, that is Uncle Sam. So celebrate Uncle Sam on Uncle Sam Day. It's also National Hug Your Boss Day. Yes, you can make everyone think that you are the one sleeping with authority by hugging your boss today on Hug Your Boss Day. There you go. It's also National Peanut Butter Day. Believe it or not, peanuts are unique in the way that they combine nutritional benefits of both nuts and legumes. Yes, and if you're allergic, well, that's just nuts. And sorry for that. It's also International Chocolate Day. Yes, maybe because it's Hershey's birthday, or maybe it's the birthday of the writer of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. We don't know. It could be a coincidence. We don't know. But it's happening right here and right now. Yes, and you may not know this, but chocolate, even though it made its debut over 4,000 years ago in Mesopotamia, chocolate can now be found everywhere. So whether you're a fan of dark chocolate, white chocolate, hot chocolate, Who knows? There's no denying the decadence of this rich delicacy. And you can put chocolate in my peanut butter, or I could dip my nut in your chocolate. You never know. But if it happens, you know we're going to have a party. So have a fun time on International Chocolate Day. I'm having trouble. My tongue is like... My tongue is like hanging on the lips of my tongue and teeth. I don't know what's happening. My tongue is just not functioning. Yes. All right. Another holiday for today. Yes. Defy Superstition Day. Yes. Today, you can defy any superstition that you may have, because superstitions, believe it or not, is the belief or practice of events or processes that are just not explained by science or by reason. Yes. Yes, there are superstitious beliefs held in every culture, and you might be surprised to learn that most superstitions may have actually started with a logical reasoning and over time just maybe got blown out of proportion, kind of like what people say on the news. But whatever superstition you may find, today is the day to defy those beliefs and just go your own way. Defy it. Defy superstition. On Defy Superstition Day. There you go. And going along those lines, today just happens to be Supernatural Day. And if you don't know what Supernatural is, it is the American dark fantasy television drama created by Eric Kripke, because it first broadcast on this day in 2005 on the WB. And the series follows two brothers as they hunt demons, ghosts, monsters, and other supernatural beings. And ever since its debut in 2005, the series has garnered a dedicated fan base from all over the world. I, for one, am one and love the TV show for the 15 years that it was out. And if you don't get a chance, download it or binge watch it. It is a fun show. All right. It's also National Celiac Disease Awareness Day. Bet you can't say that 10 times real fast. But it is a good time to examine this little-known disease that affects over 3 million Americans. Yes, celiac disease is a genetic autoimmune disorder in which a person who suffers from this affliction cannot consume gluten. Yes, gluten, a protein found in wheat, rye, or barley. It afflicts the person's immune system, and it responds by attacking the small intestines and inhibiting the absorption of important nutrients. And if left diagnosed or untreated, celiac disease can lead to other disorders, including cancer, osteoporosis, or infertility. So today is National Celiac Disease Awareness Day, and we're going to free the glutens. There you go. All right. Today just happens to be, in case you didn't know, Positive Thinking Day. Yes. Now, it's easy to be pessimistic and cynical about things, which is not entirely bad because it prepares you for the worst. However, too much negativity can have an adverse impact on our emotional well-being. Research says that you can prolong your life with happiness and optimism. That's true. So on Positive Thinking Day and other days as well, train yourself to see the bright side of every situation and try to keep an attitude, a positive attitude, always, especially on Positive Thinking Day, which is today. And even though we may be cynical on this show and pessimistic, we do it in a tongue-in-cheek fashion for the most part, and we love to think positive. And that's why we present all of this stuff on our show tonight. And it's all for you. And let's see who is with us tonight. Well, we got Evans in the house. We have George. George, welcome to the show. We have our very own man, myth, and legend, Bob Dammit.
Hello.
Hey, he's right here with us.
Trying to think positive.
You're going to be positive tonight.
No, I'm not.
Oh, come on.
I don't know how.
How? I'm very positive.
I know.
You just got a new Mac Air.
Yeah, on sale.
And
it was on sale this weekend at Best Buy for $200 off.
So that's awesome.
You can't get $200 off on an Apple product like ever.
So no, you can't get any kind of discount.
I'd jump on that one.
Yeah. And so, ladies and gentlemen, I received his old.
My 11-year-old one.
MacBook Air.
It's old.
But it's like. It's like
new to you.
It's brand new to me. I've never owned a MacBook Air.
I even have the box for it at home.
Wow.
I gave you that.
Wow. I don't know what I'd do with that box.
You keep it because you can't throw them away.
You can't throw them away?
It's like an iPhone box. You can't throw it. It's like, oh, it's you know, so I nice. Have,
I have iPhone boxes, and I no longer have that iPhone.
I know. I do, too.
Because I traded it in to get the new one.
You can't throw that box away because it's so well made. It's like, wow, this is such a nice box.
You see? That's positive.
It's positive. It's like, positive. Why are you keeping that box? It's like, oh, because it's such a, you know, it's a nice box.
Oh, my goodness.
So well made.
Yes.
So the Apple had several announcements yesterday.
Oh.
They announced the new iPhone 15.
Right.
They're doing away with the Lightning port, going with USB-C, lots of other developments and things.
Now, but what?
They are no longer going to offer leather products on anything.
Leather?
Leather, no leather watch bands.
Leather,
leather, no leather keychains for their little spot tracker things.
Is there a reason?
They just want to be, you know, they want to be carbon neutral by 2030 or something.
Carbon neutral.
Yeah, they want to. So everything is recycled and repurposed and reusable and stuff like that. So,
wow.
Speaking of throwing the box away, they're not going to use any plastic in their packaging going forward.
Okay.
So they announced all of this initiative. You know, the Apple, the ring, the UFO thing, that is fully solar powered.
The ring?
Yeah, the Apple headquarters, it's a big UFO ring.
Oh, okay.
Versus...
And it's fully solar?
One Infinite Way was their old headquarters.
Okay.
But
that was a while ago.
It's back in my time.
Yeah, right.
I miss the Icon Garden.
Right.
And yeah. And Clarice the dog cow.
The dog cow.
Well, that's how far back I go with Apple.
Wow.
But yeah, their whole headquarters, their whole campus is fully solar powered.
Wow.
And so yeah, but it's a good initiative by them, by a giant corporation with that kind of money.
Mm-hmm.
Which is weird because I remember when they were like a week from going bankrupt.
Yeah.
And Michael Dell said he would sell the company and give the money back to the shareholders, which pissed Steve Jobs off. And look at where they are now.
Yeah.
And where's Michael Dell?
Gone.
Yeah. Dude, you got a Dell. That was the worst thing Dell ever did, is get rid of that stoner kid. I'm serious. They got rid of the stoner kid and it's like, well, there goes all of our marketing.
Uh-huh.
You know? Nobody's like cared about Adele. It's like, you fired a stoner kid. It's like, yeah.
Wow.
Oh, well.
Wow.
But anyway,
do
yeah,
they still they make Dells?
Yeah, they still make Dells. Dells big in corporate.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like you can start an account with Dell.
Okay.
Dell, Lenovo, and HP are probably the three big ones for the corporate.
HP. Yeah, there's a lot of HP stuff.
Ugh, HP.
Yeah, so do I. I own a printer from HP, and everything's web based. Everything is web based, and I've come upon the notion that anything that's web based is junk.
Yeah,
it doesn't work.
Mm-hmm.
Because you have to tie in everything to an internet or Wi-Fi or whatever. And iDoc, welcome to the show. So yeah, I am totally like anything that if someone says, oh, well, we're going to do something web-based, I don't like it.
Cloud-based.
Cloud-based, no.
HP printers, when you first install them, at least on a PC, I know we are fully Macintosh here, but when you install their drivers on a PC, it kind of tries to automatically sign you up for a subscription to get monthly ink shipped to you.
Yes.
And yes. It's like, no, I really don't want, you know, ink that I'm not going to use now, automatically shipped to me.
I actually have that.
But the thing is, going to and HP.
It's scary. I'll tell you why.
We had a large format HP printer at work. And I plugged in one of the cartridges. It said, this is too old to use. This nice. Cartridge has expired.
Yeah. That's
what? It's fresh out of the box.
Nope.
We determined it's expired.
Yeah, it has a fresh date.
They were $70 each for these cartridges.
A fresh date. That's one of the things. Because everything's web-based and everything dialed in to their network.
Right.
They can tell you the serial numbers
of
the cartridge that you're using, as well as how many, everything, how many papers you're printing, how many things I called them because I thought it was weird that I didn't get a cartridge for my printer for a while. So I called them up, called their service department. I was like, you know, I'm wondering, am I going to get a new ink for my car? I haven't gotten one in a while because I'm on a plan. It's like $4 and I print like, I said 50 pages a month or something like that.
Yeah.
And max. And I hardly do anything like that. I hardly use it. And so they were like, I got like the cheapest one.
Yeah.
And they knew everything. They didn't know what I printed, but they knew that I printed like
the page count.
Yeah. They had a page count. They had how much ink was actually in the cartridge. They knew the serial number. They're like, but don't you have, another color cartridge with this? I'm like, yes, I got it. But you didn't use that yet. How come you put in this other cartridge that you must have purchased at Best Buy on?
Wow.
They knew everything about every single product.
Throw this away.
Yeah, they knew everything about every product that I did. And I was like, holy crap, that was scary.
Now, a former friend of ours, who I'm not going to mention the name, but you know who it was.
I know who it is.
He had an HP printer, all-in-one scanner thing in it, and it could print CDs and stuff. And there was a little plastic gear in the side that cracked.
Uh-oh.
And the printer just wouldn't work.
It wouldn't work.
Online, and it's like everybody's cracked this gear.
Okay.
And you have to throw the entire printer out.
What?
Because the gear cracked.
You couldn't get a new gear. No. You couldn't like glue it back together. You couldn't use a paper clip.
People were 3D printing them to get it to work again because you couldn't get it repaired by HP.
Wow. Yeah. Wow, that's messed up.
So he was like, "Nope, I'm
done."
He took it right out to the trash, threw it away, and bought a Epson.
I like Epsons.
Shaquille O'Neal's plugging Epson now with the.
He'll plug anything.
Refillable ink cartridge.
He'll plug anything. I think we have a Tony B recently in our house.
I hear him. I think you caught me. I was trying to hide, but here I am.
We're talking
That's
about
awesome
HP printers.
Yes.
Oh, my balls were itching, so that makes sense. Oh,
hey, there you go. Yeah. I just looked in this pile of paperwork and I found something, and I'm going to do a drum roll.
Pile of paperwork.
Yes.
That sounds like you were working.
This came in the mail today.
It wasn't my package, was it?
No, it wasn't.
It's a residual.
This is a residual check for myself.
What?
A residual.
Oh, why do you get all the money?
Holy crap. Because I wrote and produced.
But we're the talent. We're going on strike.
Yeah.
This is, I got a nice little surprise here from.
You're welcome, Steve. I was listening to your music. All right.
Thank you. If you were listening to the music, I appreciate
that. Is
that
from Podbean or something?
No,
You're in my playlist. Your album cup. You see your album sometimes on the television.
Oh yeah, which album? Do you know?
Is the one with the kid on the front.
Oh, that's the new one. That's the one from
Poking Holes in Ants or something.
Yeah. Playing God with Insects?
That's the one.
Yes, that's the newer one. That's where I was. I was in a real dark place for that. I was like,
it was pretty cool. It wasn't like Nights on Broadway, but it was nice.
It's a Nights on Broadway.
So what were you saying?
We got to do a parody.
Oh yeah.
What were you saying about pygmies?
Oh,
pygmies.
Oh, yes. Yes.
During the opening, he said something about pygmies sacrificing you on an altar.
Yes. It was saying, pygmy teens are threatening, if your God is not stronger, we will sacrifice you on an altar. And I saw this on an envelope. And I'm
on
like,
an envelope? What?
Yes. It was being sent to somebody. And
sent me a picture of
it. And I snapped a quick picture of it. And it was with other mail from what was his name? He ran for president. Played bass guitar with Ted Nugent. Huckabee.
Oh yeah,
Huckabee. Yeah, Huckabee, and it was like a whole bunch of like propaganda stuff for. It was just Trump and Mike Huckabee, like and
this mailer was
and then this and this and this just caught my eye. If your God is not stronger, we will sacrifice you on an altar. And it said Pygmy Teens threatened to do this. And I'm like, what is happening?
You sent me the picture.
And I sent you the picture, and you're like, holy, what?
I'm like, there's what so many, is, not, none of this makes
so,
sense.
It's so weird. It was weird.
From like the Jesus Film Project.
Yes.
So we went, I, of course, went into the Googleizer, and I found their webpage, and I found the story behind what this meant. Because the envelope just says, Pygmy Teen says, I should bring it up.
We're going to kill you.
We're going to
sacrifice. On an altar.
Literally just one sentence. Yeah. And I guess it was.
Please don't.
I know, right? It's like, it catches your eye, don't it?
But the story behind it was they had like some kind of like biblical God challenge.
Yeah. So basically these
teenager and these missionaries.
Yeah. The missionaries go into this African tribe. And that had
our God, and then I guess the storm started, and it was like, oh my goodness.
Yeah, so yeah, there's like winds and rain and stuff, and yeah. So they were all thinking that their gods were fighting each other, and yeah. And whose God's okay. Better than them, and I was just like, what is wow. This? And
traveled all that way for that.
Yeah, and
I don't know.
Wow, this story's falling flat.
It is.
I wonder if the film's going to fall flat too.
I guess not. I don't know. You could stream it flat. Online.
It could be a hip new Jesus thing. But you never know.
I guess they do missionaries all over the world to tell people about.
I just didn't know pygmy teens were a problem.
I didn't know that you could call it, like, I didn't know. I don't know that pygmy is a.
Is it not a.
I don't think it's like very politically correct.
It's anymore. Not politically correct.
I don't
like,
know.
It's like you can't say midget anymore.
It's kind of like that.
Ah,
like,
come on.
I don't. You can know. Still say midget. Yes, you can. But
I don't know where
I'll say it, but they'll probably punch you in the balls.
No. They'll get mad and go,
what comedian said
they ain't
said
kicking
that,
you.
What comedian was it in who the said, the world smells differently to a midget?
Wasn't that, who said that?
It could have been Carlin.
Carlin.
I don't know.
Could but be.
I don't know where pig is. I don't know
but
where
I just,
are from.
They're in Africa.
Yeah.
In Central Africa, but I'm just
I remember
like,
Frank Zappa sang about pygmy ponies.
Yeah, exactly. So exactly with going to Montana.
Oh, that's the one.
Yes,
that's the one.
Yep. Moving to Montana soon.
The pygmy pony over by the dental floss. Bush.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. So that was a thing.
Pygmy
that,
teenagers.
Pygmy those, teens.
Yeah.
Those damn pygmy teens. I just didn't know that they were a
problem. They're getting out of hand.
Lots of stories.
We'll ride like cowboys into the dawn.
Into the dawn.
To Montana.
The thing is, a story like that sounds so made up, but it's like so badly made up.
Yes.
It's like, it just sounds so, it's like, you guys need better writers.
Yes.
Oh my Lord! Well, yes.
How do you do that with the writer's strike going on?
No, I don't know.
Oh my goodness!
But yeah, if you're going to come up with a story to convince people to give you money, come up with a better one.
Yeah.
That reminds me. A long time ago, I was in San Diego, and this—I don't know if he was a homeless guy. I can't assume he was homeless, but he asked us for money, panhandler, and he said he was, you know. Needed a bus ride back to Philadelphia. Ooh. And instantly we said, no, that's not a good story. Tell us a better one.
What?
Yeah. And he said, okay. He goes, and he's standing in front of us. He goes, I lost my legs in Vietnam. And it's like, you win. Here's your $5. It's like, we don't like that story. Tell a better one. And he would instantly tell us, you know,
wow,
some other different story. You know, it's like, okay, it's funny.
I need $5 to go to Philly.
Yeah, it's
from
like
California.
Nah, it's not a good story. Tell us a better
one. Cali.
It's okay. Wow. I lost my legs in Vietnam, and my wife left me. And he's standing there. It's like, wearing shorts, dude. funny as hell. Or the best one was the first panhandler that would approach us. We would give them $5 and say, okay, you're our bodyguard. Now you have to hang out with us for the rest of the night and keep everybody else from bothering us.
Ah, there you go.
So it's like, you walk ahead of us and don't let anybody bug near us.
You. Okay.
And sure as shit, we're walking down the street and these panhandlers would come up. Hey, you have any cigarettes? Leave these gentlemen alone. Can't you see they're busy? And it's like,
you're nice.
We'd buy a beer. You'd take them out for the night.
That's great.
And yeah, just hire them. It's like, here's your, just keep people from bugging us. The last time I was there, now they've cleaned up San Diego quite a bit, but the last time I was there, I was stumble drunk walking back to the hotel.
Mm-hmm.
And another panhandler walked up, asked me for some spare change or something. I was like, I'll give you $2 if you can tell me what time it is. And he looked at it. He wasn't wearing a wristwatch. He goes, I'll be right back. And he sprinted to the liquor store. And I could see him just run his ass. And he's like, he asked the cashier, what time it was. He came back and goes, it's 10:45. Holy shit, that's late. Here's your money. I got to get back to my But yeah.
Now, Tony, you just recently went on a journey.
I went to Colorado.
Yeah.
It was quite the journey. We went over that kind of I missed the show, I guess, twice. I lost my phone.
Crazy. Yeah.
But it was a great trip. It was awesome. It was awesome.
That's awesome. Hey, Saturday Night Smoke is with us tonight. Welcome on a Wednesday. That's awesome.
Now, break your phone broke, right? You did it break?
Yeah. I got to Philadelphia. First thing, fell on the concrete floor. And it was one of those weird screens. And I was like, oh, God, this is not going to be good.
Nope.
I have to go into TSA now. There's no turning back now.
No. Nope. Yeah, that's...
I had to keep going. So I was like, okay, I'll just figure this out as I go. That's part of the adventure.
Yep.
Wow.
Yeah. Mama Bear, welcome.
That kind of drives home how dependent we are on
our phones.
Stupid phones.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, it's your life.
I try to stop that. I realized that I spent way too much time on my phone, and too many different things were happening on my phone, and I put it away. I come home from work, and I literally put it away.
Yeah,
I don't
that's
really
a good idea.
Use my phone. Because I got an iPad and laptops and everything else. I don't use my phone because everything
you have
is
all kinds of other
else.
Stimuli.
Right. Yeah, right. Yeah.
But it kind of irritates me that we can't go to the baseball game without a freaking phone.
Oh, man.
Like your virtual tickets.
Without a what?
Without
a phone.
Your phone.
Yeah, everything's virtual tickets.
Oh,
now.
Right. Right.
Like when we went
will
to
call
the
and everything.
Yeah.
They're going to
get
rid of will call, so.
Yeah, went to the movies the other week.
They wouldn't even, I went to the movies.
And it's like you have to pre-book your seat on your phone, get a barcode, and then you go to the movie theater and scan your barcode for it to print the tickets.
They don't even have the front desk open anymore. Yeah. They go to the concession stand now. So that whole front window where you used to get your tickets, it's empty.
Yeah.
That whole part is empty. Yeah. And, that was the whole point. You go to get your tickets at the booth.
But the thing is, in Sarasota... It's like there's the ticket booth up front with nobody in it. Mm-hmm. You walk in to the lobby, and there used to be customer service desk where nobody there. But on the customer service desk is a bunch of scanners and ticket printers.
Yeah.
So
you scan
your thing to get the ticket anyway.
Yeah.
It's like, what?
It's bizarre. It's bizarre.
Yeah, it was really weird. And then, the bucket of popcorn was $10.
Yeah.
Aye, aye, aye. It's all air. You're buying air. All those voids.
The container the popcorn is in costs more than the popcorn.
Yes. That's true.
Yes.
That popcorn is pure profit for the...
How is this place in business? It's unreal.
Because they sell the popcorn. That's how they make their money. They don't make the money off of ticket sales. They make it off the concessions.
You pull wrong tooth. I can't eat my popcorn.
To round out your little story about travel, I had that challenge. I got my phone was nil, and I got through anyway. So, hey, we could do it. We can do it.
It is true. Yes. Yes, you can.
You needed a printed boarding pass and all of that stuff.
Unless you're listening to us.
Thankfully, I had that hard copy, so I was okay that way.
But the thing is, you have to scan your phone's barcode to get the printed the boarding pass at the front.
Wow.
Yeah, unless, you know.
That's crazy.
It's weird. It's like, how can we eliminate people? And it's like, no, I like dealing with people.
Wow.
I liked going into the bank and talking to Joanne and withdrawing the gas money, you know, because I don't like skimming my card at the gas pump. You know, there's something to be said for the old way of doing things, you know.
Gotcha. I mean, you know? Interaction, the communication with people. Well,
it keeps people employed.
That it does.
And that's not a bad
unless you're thing. In a right to work state, then it doesn't matter.
Yeah, then it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Oh, we can
right to work states.
Go to the ATM and wave your card in front of it and put in your PIN. And...
Well, that only reminds me of one thing.
This or that.
This or that.
Yes.
This or that.
You went 31 minutes without this or that.
What? I should say. What?
What?
Well, we did a lot of things. We had the opening, of course, and then we had the Pygmy Talk, the Pygmy Teens. So that was
HP.
Yeah, and HP.
That was scary.
It was, yeah. So, but the Pygmy Teen story. So that added a little bit of a thing. But tonight's this or that, folks. Because Bob and I swapped gears here. I'm going to say cake or pie. Tonight's this or that is cake or pie.
But that was cupcake or donut. What was the other one?
Cake or pie.
I'm going to go with cake. With buttercream icing. Yeah.
Wow. There you go. Wow. Nice. That's all right. Cake or pie? So you let us know what you guys think. If you like cake, or if you like pie, you know, it could be angel food cake, could be chocolate cake, it could be red velvet, or it could be a pie. It could be an apple pie, a cherry pie. You know, what do you like? You know,
they should put icing on pies too. Why not? That.
Well, sure, you got whipped cream.
Yeah, that's true.
Mm-hmm. Ice cream and pie.
Not cool
ice
whip.
Ice cream and cake.
I don't like cool whip.
No?
No.
It's made from oil or some crap.
No oil. It's chemical based.
Yeah.
Came out of a lab.
Wow. Kind of like prefer, chickens.
I prefer pie.
You like pie?
Yeah, because my nan used to have like a cottage industry in her kitchen of baking pies for church members.
Oh,
she would take orders, and one of the things she did when she was retired, and she made all kinds of crazy
Mama stuff. Bear says cake.
Yeah.
Oh. Hello. Yeah. Welcome back, Mama Bear. We missed you.
Welcome back.
Yes, we missed you last week. That was
welcome back.
We were like, oh, where's Mama Bear?
Well, it wasn't like.
Hello, Bob was like,
where's Mo? Because we were talking about Canada.
Yeah, we were talking. There was a bunch of things going on in Canada. Yeah. Canada.
I can't remember. Darn.
I can't remember. Yeah. It was last week. So, but
should have been.
It was a week ago.
Yeah, it was a week ago. We don't remember what we said a week ago. We don't know. We don't remember.
We had for something breakfast.
Something about poutine or Timmy Hortons.
I don't know. All right. Like so tonight's Biden. This or that's. Cake or pie.
This or that.
And that's tonight's this or that. So if Smoke, if you got going on, iDoc, Eric, everybody, George.
This or that.
Tonight's this or that is cake or pie. Let us know and we will tally it up at the end of the night. Right now, cake's up 3-1.
Yeah, it's more popular.
It's more popular.
I mean, birthday cake is like becoming the new pumpkin spice.
Now that is next week's, I think, pumpkin or pumpkin spice.
Wow,
did you see
Frosty's, Wendy's has a pumpkin spice Frosty.
Oh, wow.
Did you see that?
Yeah, I did see that.
Just came out of the pumpkin spice frosty.
Yeah, so why not just pumpkin? Why is it going to be pumpkin spice?
I don't know.
It's because of all the associative spices, the comfort spices.
Put in the pumpkins.
I guess. I don't know.
I don't either.
It was just weird.
Cinnamon, clove.
We're going to
all that like kind of.
We're going to send some pygmy teens flavors after their ass.
Watch out.
And the woods get
sacrificed on an altar.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sacrificed on an altar. God almighty.
Did you know it's positive thinking day, Tony?
Well, I do that every day.
There it is. Yes. Exactly. See, that's how it should be.
Is it?
Yes, that's how it should be. Thank you so much, Tony.
It's okay to gripe, but try to think of a solution, too.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
No, but the solutions don't work.
You don't know that unless you try. Yeah.
Well, that's true. It doesn't have to work. Just try. You may be surprised.
Exactly.
All experts agree. No, they don't. They disagree. They had a fucking fist fight. The experts had a fist fight and they could not come up with a decision.
Who are the experts? Give me names.
I know, right?
Don't just tell me 8 out of 10 dentists. Is that all the dentists know. You know?
I know. Who are these dentists?
Yeah. 8 out of 10 dentists in this town agree.
Oh, man. Hey, Tony, police reports from Burning Man came out today.
Burning Man?
Yeah. Did you ever go to Burning Man?
Well, forgive me. What is that?
I'm gonna guess you haven't gone.
I take it. Yes. It's like an event. It's almost like a Woodstock, but in a desert.
It's every Labor Day, I believe.
Labor Day weekend. Burning Man.
It's like a week.
Week in the desert? No wonder he's burning, man.
So they have this huge, like, wooden structure that looks like a man, and then they would burn it at the end of
the
end of the festival. So
the sun goes down on Sunday.
An effigy.
Yes. But it's huge.
That's just
it's
massive.
It's 20 like, to 30 feet.
Yeah, and I say it's like four stories.
Yeah.
Well, why does that just not sound like fun to me?
A lot of people, you know, it's a lot of music, a lot of people. It was 80,000 people this year.
They've been doing it a long time.
I remember in the 90s when they were doing it.
Yeah, I was invited to go. I knew a bunch of people that were going, and they were like, hey, come along with us. And I was like, it doesn't sound. I think you're going to die.
Burning Man.
Spend a week out in the open desert.
Yeah, you got to bring all your own stuff. You got to
bring
water,
all your own water and everything. And they don't use money.
And then you got to take it with you.
You got to take it out. And they don't use money. Everything's bartering. It's either barter or a gift.
Yeah.
Yep. They don't have money in Black Rock City. It's all bartering or a gift. No cars except for the special arch cars.
Did that take you in and out?
Yeah. Fascinating.
And they are strictly held to 15 miles per hour speed limit. You can't have personal vehicles.
Yeah. There's only a lot of people with mics or bikes.
So if you're going, you pretty much have to take a bike with you.
Yeah.
But I don't know. It looks like a heck of a lot of fun. It's one of those things where it's like, had I known what that was when the offer came about, I probably should have done it.
Yeah, like Chris Rock was there, and he had, I guess him and Diplo, they got picked up because they were trying to walk out of there and they couldn't get out.
Yeah, Tony, it rained all week in the it's a dry lake bed and it rained all week.
So it was everyone was stuck
in the mud.
Oh my God! And I would have hated it.
Yeah, it was like the mud was up to their thighs.
Mosquitoes.
I'm sorry. Their shins. It was like it was like maybe like 10 inches of mud, and then they have porta potties there. And so when they were going to the bathroom, there was actually more mud in the porta potties than what they were just walking through.
Well, I can't imagine they could get in and clean those out either.
No. And you know, that was the thing. Nobody can get in or out. There's no fresh water. There's no.
Yeah.
They can't even helicopter in. The only way to get in is via car.
No, there's a airport strip like a small Cessna plane airport strip.
Yeah, well, this because of the rain. But
because of the rain, they were
they were stuck.
Yeah, everybody was stuck there, and I believe they blocked traffic entering into Black Rock City. Like they closed the road to get there. It's a very small town outside of there. Mm-hmm. So the small town, it's like this is their 1 week that drives the town for the entire year. The people that come through.
I just thought, you know, back in the 90s, I just thought it was like a place that everyone just...
It just sounded to me like crazy. A bunch of hippies going out to the desert to drop acid.
Yeah, that is exactly what I thought it was,
too. And it's like, I you guys are going to die.
And now, there's all these celebrities...
Well, now
top models.
Yeah, now it's a whole influencer bullshit thing.
Oh, there's a thing there. I was watching television and people that were saying, content creators.
Steve, you were watching television?
I was. And everybody who was on this show were quote-unquote content creators.
You mean like they had like a podcast or something?
Like a podcast, but...
Yeah, those people suck.
I know, right? But these are... they were...
You're a content creator, Steve.
I am a content creator, but I actually create stuff.
Yeah.
These people didn't know how to cook an egg.
They couldn't boil an egg, right?
They couldn't boil an egg, and I'm watching this. It was a cooking show, and these people were like, I'm a content creator. And they didn't know anything about anything. They were like, well, what do you do?
They were frauds.
I'm like, what the heck? I'm like, I just came upon the conclusion that when you acknowledge yourself as being a content creator, mm-hmm. we don't go around saying, I'm a content creator.
No, but you do go around saying, I have a podcast.
I do have a podcast.
Yeah, we do.
And we do have lots of CDs. Are
content creators.
Man.
We also have a YouTube channel.
We don't really use it yet. Oh, speaking of the YouTube, mm-hmm. we just got word that the One Chip Challenge has been taken off the shelves.
I actually got an email from Amazon warning me about my previous order of the One Chip Challenge.
What?
like, please do not consume it.
Oh, my
God. And, you know, if you gave it to anybody, please let them know that there's...
Now,
like, yeah,
ladies and gentlemen,
they took it down.
Yeah,
someone died. Someone died.
Some teenager
did something somehow, and he ate this chip and died. And it's
at
like
school.
It's like,
but
Ozzy
hundreds
all over.
Of people before him did not. So one guy dies, like, or is a lot of people dying? Is that what's going on?
One kid died. He ate it at school on a dare or something.
And
he went to, you know, the nurse, they sent him home.
Yeah, with an upset stomach, and he went to sleep and never woke up.
I think he had a heart attack or something.
Yeah, why didn't she just give him some milk?
He might have had a condition or something where he didn't realize.
He probably did. But of course, it's not going to stop his parents from freaking out and trying to sue the company.
They
only put like skull and crossbones and said, take this seriously, do not eat it.
It's like when we were young, someone listened to Ozzy and died, and it's Ozzy's fault.
Oh, yeah.
So now we can't do the One Chip Challenge for our YouTube channel.
No.
See, that was like, we had fun.
I don't know if I want to do it again.
I know. Other than the immense pain that we went through.
That was not a good experience.
I thought it was a fun time. We all got together on a Saturday night, and we all... did something crazy.
I don't know about your idea of fun.
Oh, man. You know, it was
a little masochistic.
Remember that night
we all got together and put jumper cables on our nipples? That was fun. sucked.
Right.
Yeah. Right? That chip not only tasted bad, it hurt like hell.
It did. It was hard to breathe.
I couldn't see straight.
It was hard to breathe.
The whole room went blurry.
Yeah. And it was like you're...
It was an overwhelming of the senses. And
I know my heart rate went up through the
exactly,
roof.
And that's why... And apparently this year's chip is even hotter than last year's chip.
Wow.
So that's why they pulled it. They went, you know, maybe we took it up a little too far.
Wow.
And the manufacturer voluntarily
took it off,
withdrew it from the market.
Wow. So, wow, that's messed up.
Yeah.
But I mean, I just, well, we were hoping to give people a show.
Their regular ghost pepper chips are enough.
Their ghost pepper chips?
Oh, my God.
Speaking of,
I ate like ghost half peppers. A bag of them.
Speaking of, what's in that bag right there? What's left? What's left?
The Cool Ranch chips are left.
Well, then, that should be a no-brainer.
I think they're, like, one of them spicy.
One of them is spicy. See, yeah. We can do that, right? We can do that tonight.
Well, Tony doesn't like us munching chips in his ear.
Yeah, that's true.
I don't think the audience likes
We should take a poll, see if they like hearing crunching.
Do you like hearing us chomp on chips?
Who is crunching the, into the... Oh, man.
And they are a little stale.
They are stale, but still, they're...
I do it. You know, I did it once as a gag, like I had chips. Well, it wasn't... I didn't write it. The Panera Bread didn't have bread, so I had chips.
Oh, there you go.
Like, what the F, you know.
Oh, man. Tony, do you have ass-breaking news at the top of the hour?
At the top of the hour.
Yes. All right. Well, and if, why don't we just do something crazy?
Bullshit or not?
Let's do some bullshit or not, huh? Yeah. Yeah.
Bullshit. I'm playing bullshit.
Bullshit. Or not.
All right, folks. Bullshit or not, that's what's happening right here and right now. In case you didn't already know, I'm going to give you some headlines, and you're going to have to decide which one is actually
bullshit
or not. And there you go. All right, here's the first one. Girl develops rabies 20 years after dog bite. In a case that has puzzled doctors, a girl who was bit by a dog developed rabies 20 years later. Next one. Here it is. Boy diagnosed with first case of cowpox in more than 10 years after calf nibbled his hand. Yes. Cowpox. Talk about delayed effects. Over a decade after feeding a calf by hand, a boy developed a hideous case of cowpox.
Yeah, but you don't get chicken pox from chickens.
How do you get... Okay, so is it the girl developing rabies 20 years after the dog bite? Or a boy diagnosed with the first case of cowpox in more than 10 years after getting his hand nibbled by the calf? All right.
Wait, read that cowpox.
Cowpox? Okay, hold on. Let's see. Boy diagnosed with first case of cowpox in more than 10 years after calf nibbled his hand. Talk about delayed effects. Over a decade after feeding a calf by hand, a boy developed a hideous case of cowpox.
Okay, they wrote that statement weird.
It was weird.
It says first case of cowpox in over 10 years, and then it says that he developed cowpox 10 years after the bite.
Yes.
So, what is it?
So, I don't know. It's so...
I'm going with the rabies.
You're going with rabies?
Yeah, because the cowpox one is just stupid.
What do
rabies.
You think,
Tony? Rabies.
You're going rabies?
Yeah.
All right.
I got rabies.
Any other takers, folks? Zwerk Bazoo. Are you going to be... That
sounds like an episode of House MD.
I know, right?
What could be doing this to this patient?
Right. Here it is, folks. Ladies and gentlemen, it was actually both stories are scary, but only the cowpox is real.
Really?
As reported by the Mirror UK back in 2018. That actually happened.
So you can get cowpox from a cow.
It's a decade after you get bit.
But you don't
and
get
nibbled.
Chicken pox from a chicken.
No, you don't get
you
chicken
don't get
pox
monkey
from a
chicken. Pox from a monkey.
No.
You know, if he played his cards right, he could have the whole zoo.
I guess. Oh, boy. All right, here's the next one, folks. All right. Weirdo or humanitarian? Why do people donate their pee to science? People who donate urine,
they want it because they have a pee fetish.
That's right. See, people who donate their urine to science have several motivations, but the most common is a perverse desire to share their pee with others. Here's the next one. Money or altruism? What motivates people to donate their feces to medicine?
Oh, God.
Most people who donate their poop to science do it out of the desire to help others, not out of the monetary gain. So which one is it, folks? Is it the...
That's a thing.
Is it why people donate their pee to science? Or what motivates people to donate their feces to medicine?
Oh, man.
They want to know if they have colorectal cancer.
Ah.
California. Is that
rectal gonorrhea?
Yeah.
It'll really burn.
Oh, California hot tub. Rectal gonorrhea.
Yes. That's awesome. All right. So is it the...
We're not going to take it sitting down. I guess you can't.
How do you find out about these programs?
Which one? The donating your poop?
Either one. Yeah. I guess one of them is false. But I don't know.
Go to the shit and piss fetish site or something.
Yeah.
Wow.
I don't want to Google.
Wow. .org.
Well,
I just Google urine donation.
I don't know. So
you're in luck.
You're in luck.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go with I don't want to go with either of these.
Yes. Which one do you think, Tony? Is it donating pee to science or feces to medicine?
I'll go with the pee. We'll try pee.
You're going to pee?
As much as I hate to say it, I know that a fecal transplant is a real thing. So I'm going to say
a fecal transplant.
Yes, it's a real thing.
they how do you transfer someone's poop?
They literally do it by a tube down your nose into your gut to replenish your gut bacteria.
Oh,
it's a real thing.
The things you learn on this show, people. We are a fully educational program at this point.
It's true.
And these are things that...
If your gut bacteria dies off, they have to give you a fecal transplant from someone else's...
Not only do we learn about having it... So Milton Hershey's birthday, we're talking about...
Gross.
Gross. Those are unrelated things. So I'm going to go with number... I'm going to go with number two.
Well, number two. All right, folks. All right. Donating your pee to science or donating your feces to medicine, it just happens to be the only poop, the deal is real. As reported by Science Daily, that poop thing is happening. Ay.
Man.
I don't know.
G.G. Allen could have found a new job.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. All right. Well, we can't have a this or that without something crazy. So we're going to do a bandit. Which bandit?
You said this or that.
Is not. Oh, I said this or that?
Yeah.
I meant bullshit or not. I'm sorry. What?
Bullshit.
What's wrong with me? It must be getting late. I don't know. Which bandit is not bullshit? Who is the Palpatine bandit?
Somehow he returned.
Yes. Is it
somehow
a bank? Yes, the Palpatine bandit. Is it a bank robber with a henchman in a Darth Vader mask? Is it a bank robber wearing a hoodie? Or is it a bank robber with a taser? So who is the Palpatine bandit? A bank robber with a henchman in a Darth Vader mask? A bank robber wearing a hoodie? Or a bank robber with a taser?
I'm going to say the hoodie.
You're going to say the hoodie?
Yeah, I'm just wildly guessing.
What do you think, Tony? Can you imagine what the Palpatine Bandit looks like if you're a Star Wars fan?
I want it to be Darth Vader. I really do.
The henchman? Is henchman Darth Vader? Well, we're going to do this. It'll be a drum roll. Ah, Bob, you got it right again.
Oh, there you go.
This thief had a hoodie much like the Star Wars baddie Emperor Palpatine, as reported by Central Oregon News Channel 21. So there you go.
There you have it.
That, folks, is...
Bullshit or not?
Bullshit! I'm planning bullshit!
All right. That's bullshit or not. Oh, man. Whew. We have 5 minutes till ass breaking news with Tony B recently. Yes.
Coming at you. Coming at us.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Could have had almost a perfect segue with the fecal donations.
The fecal really? Donations with ass breaking news.
Right into Dr. Linda.
Into Dr. Linda. Wow. Right. It could have been a whole freaking shit show.
Exactly.
Ay. What is up with me tonight? I don't know. I'm having trouble talking. I'm just not right.
Are you sleeping well?
I don't know.
What's going on? Open up to us.
I don't know.
Open your ass to us.
Yes. I don't know. I'm having back issues. I'm having some back issues. So I had several doctor's appointments today in regards to that.
Several.
And I had to, I might be getting an MRI soon. So there you go. But, other than that,
not a cat scan.
Meow.
No, not a cat scan. So I'm going to be
what
sitting
are you doing
in
with that cat? This is a cat scan, sir. Ah, okay.
Oh. Ay, ay, ay. Well, we got like 3 more minutes. We can do a really quick one. Let's do this.
True or false?
All right. I'm just going to read out a statement.
Okay.
You have to decide whether it's true or false.
Okay.
We got it, Tony?
Okay.
All right. Here we go.
This is the lightning round.
This is lightning round. Fortune cookies, chow mein, and chop suey were all invented right here in the United States of America.
True.
True. True. Absolutely true.
True. That's what they're saying. And you are correct. That is a true statement. Boom, boom, boom. Here we go. Native Americans do not suffer from vertigo. Native Americans do not suffer from vertigo. True or false?
False.
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 Yeah.
Well, let's do the drum. Any other takers? Any other takers on this? Mama Bear, you're around. And we're going to do the drum roll. Do Native Americans not suffer from vertigo? It is a false statement. You guys are correct on that. That is correct.
You gave us the buzzer.
I gave you the buzzer, but I mean, the statement was false. So, so there you go. They're just people like everybody else. They can suffer from vertigo.
Right.
All right. So here's the next one. An American tourist landed at Sydney Airport. Sounds like a beginning of a joke. He hopped in a cab and asked to be taken to Ayers Rock.
Okay.
I don't know. Is it true or false? An American tourist landed at Sydney Airport in Australia, hopped in a cab, and asked to be taken to Ayers Rock.
I believe it. They don't call it Ayers Rock.
Ayers Rock? They don't call it
No, they changed the name to the Aboriginal name, which I can't remember what it is.
Oh.
But I believe it. I believe something.
So it's true?
Take me to go see that.
You're saying it's true?
I'm saying it's true, yeah.
Wow. Okay.
I can picture somebody doing something that... Well, not realizing it's way out in the middle of the outback.
It's like Australia's Burning Man, or in the middle of the desert. I don't know. That is a false statement.
Oh.
False.
So, yes. Yes. Even though I think it's known as Ayers Rock, but it's called Uluru.
Uluru.
So, yeah. I don't know. I don't know.
I don't know how close.
Why would that be false? Because you can't get there by cab. I don't know.
I don't know how far away it is from the airport.
I don't either. So that's just, it's weird. Unless we're from Australia, we wouldn't know.
No,
we wouldn't.
That's why I said true. Cause you know, I figured somebody had to do something that goofy.
Yeah. So I don't know. All right. Last one. Baseball was invented by the British.
True.
Controversy.
I don't know.
Okay.
All right.
A lot of controversy. I'm gonna say true. Okay. With an asterisk.
With an asterisk?
Yes, like the one like that's on Barry Bonds baseball.
Like Barry Bonds baseball. Okay. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna do the drum roll real quick. You guys are correct. It is true. Mm-hmm. Well done. And that, folks, was
true or false.
I believe the British game is rounders. A very similar game called Rounders.
Rounders.
School children play.
Oh.
I guess they morphed it into baseball over here.
Yeah.
The early baseball guys look very possibly English.
Yeah.
In a kind of a way.
Yeah, and they're knickers.
Yes.
and then they
have big mustaches. And, you know.
Yeah. Yeah. So, but yeah. That's what they say.
Big and, pouches.
Actually, I was in the Hall of Fame.
Mm-hmm.
Shoes.
And it mentioned that back in the late 1700s
mm-hmm.
that they had a game called Rounders. I think it was Rounders, like you were right. But they had the history of baseball.
It's interesting. But,
we stole it just like all the TV shows and made it America's pastime. America's pastime.
Yeah. Made it the world's pastime.
Yes. Yes.
Indeed.
Why is it the World Series if it's only American teams?
I know.
I don't know either.
We are the world. Shut the hell up.
We are.
We
just are.
Yes. All right. I think it's a little after 8 o'clock.
All right.
It's now that time.
Thanks, Stephen. And thank you for joining us and giving us a bit of your time here at the top of the hour on the Potluck Podcast with an audience that's international. So let's start here. I hope it's not too loud. Tell me.
Hello.
Is that right?
That's good.
It's I. This is the Ass Break Edition show for Wednesday, September the 13th, 2023. I'm Tony B. Recently coming to you live from Dover, Delaware. There is a force in this universe, Ass Breakers, and we're here to expose these asses posing as good people. One of those forces is a policymaker by the name of Bill Clinton. You know, the guy who turned the Oval Office into the Oral Office? Thanks, Bill. Now, let's not blame other workers. We're all co-workers here of one another, after all. But there is enemies to the workers. Just ask yourself, who gave away and destroyed jobs in the United States of America? All experts and workers agree NAFTA did. And Bill Clinton got that done, where his predecessor, Bush Sr., could not. Bill Clinton, this Democrat in wolf's clothes, led us down this path, solidifying Reagan's trickle-down garbage theory. Slick Willie. Slick Willie. I like that. Undermined welfare and made it incredibly inhumane to this day. By the way, I literally know of no one who wants a handout or wants to be on welfare. But give any scenario in our low-wage slave occupation state, you get right out of high school and you will proceed to enter into Bill's 21st century dystopian life. God forbid you have a medical emergency or worse, cancer. You're bankrupt. If, at worst, a long life of poverty as your residue, not a pension that was taken away long ago, that kids today have no idea what a pension really even is. This is the real American dream turned nightmare. We are an existing slave state by a way of low-wage policy and politics and attitudes. Bill Clinton played into that too, carrying on the cynical Reagan trope of welfare queen. NAFTA destroyed union jobs. But somehow, America's great, and we need to forget about Maui and focus more money for war in Ukraine with imperialistic idea of weakening Russia. That's backfiring, by the way. You remember when Norm Macdonald said on The View about, I'll let him say.
Yeah, I think we should get the homicide out of the White House and get like a fresh start, because we don't want any more murderers.
I think we should just go on to the next question.
Oh, the murderers.
Oh, Clinton, he murdered a guy.
Yeah, you know, we're not
Clinton,
you know,
he murdered a guy.
Accusations with that.
That's a little too far. Let's just go on to the next question.
Yeah.
This is not my week. What can I tell you?
Barbara Walters.
Oh, it's not mine either. I'm being very nice, okay?
Be a good boy.
And Norm is like,
You
didn't hear that?
I don't want to get into this, and I don't want to hear it, and this is not the place to make those accusations, and you're supposed to be funny. Let's get on.
I think it was hilarious.
There you go.
Nice.
This is a live show.
Not enough, Norm, but you have been properly chastised.
He's like, he's incredulous. Like, I can't believe you guys. It's a matter of record.
Let me do this.
Joy Behar is putting her mouth, her hand over his mouth.
Invited back if you don't shut up.
And then the black woman's threatening him. If you don't shut up, you're going to get kicked off or never be back on.
All right, man.
So, he said manslaughter, maybe. So, I'm not suggesting the Clintons had anything to do with this or was involved with Epstein's murder. Wait, why did I say that? Because we all can rationalize in base that a billionaire would never kill himself, right? Yet that's what the corporate CIA-attached media would have you believe. In spite of Epstein's library of information he had on the Clintons and others, that may very well be why he's out of the picture. The ugly irony about Norm, because he was battling cancer 10 years before that View episode, so it disavows the notion the Clintons had him killed. Nevertheless, don't mess with a gangster, you know? Clinton, Slick Willie, don't mess. If it's true, that is, I'm saying, do a Clinton impression. I did not have sex with Hillary. I mean, that girl. Nice. In fake news. No, wait, I got to stop doing that. In fake news, ass breaking news. Whoops. Jeez. That was loud. Sorry. With the U.S. seeing an increase in COVID cases over the last few weeks, mask mandates are in the news again, prompting Republican governors to vow to prevent their return. Data suggested due to a slight rise that masks should be enforced on humans again. They forced masks on us, but Fauci didn't get handcuffs. Fascinating. States against the mandates are like that of Texas and current Governor Greg Abbott, who recently signed a law that codifies orders from 2021 prohibiting any government entity from establishing mask or vaccine mandates and from closing businesses or schools due to COVID-19, says a spokesman for Abbott's office, Newsweek said. Arkansas, in a post to X, formerly Twitter, August 31st, Arkansas Governor Sarah Huckabee Sanders said, "As long as I'm governor, Arkansas will never lock down." Huntington Beach, Huntington Beach, the last place on earth you'd think I'd be reporting on this topic, but guess what? Their city council voted to pass a declaration that bans universal mask mandates in the city. Mississippi Governor Tate Reeves opposes any return to mask mandates in his state, saying Mississippians will not and should not submit to fear again. We will not return to widespread masking or urinating or whatever in public and COVID rules. Florida Governor Ron DeSantis has opposed mask and COVID mandates since 2020. And in recent press conferences, he doubled down on that stance, saying, "You have a civil right in Florida now to breathe fresh air. No one can force you to muzzle yourself against your own consent." Oklahoma on September 1, Governor Kevin Tits said that Oklahoma did not do lockdowns or mask mandates in 2020, and we're not starting now. In Utah, Governor Spencer Cox. I didn't have anything on this to report. They're all basically the same topic, but I agree with them. And I just wanted to say, Governor Cox. Yes. I agree, and I feel all the evidence is clear. We were lied to. I took a poll at work. They are not going to heed any lockdowns or mandates, including my bosses. I want to know, guys, what's your thoughts? And we'll end the segment with this discussion. Guys, don't forget about Dr. Linda now.
Okay.
You think?
My thought, well, first off, I wanted to let you know, I think what they were talking about, you're going back to The View. I think what Norm MacDonald was talking about was David Koresh.
Okay.
In Waco, Texas. We saw that live on television.
Okay.
And
I thought he was talking about the Whitewater guy.
No. That was Trump. Trump had him killed. And everyone said it was Hillary.
No, the Clintons had Whitewater.
Whitewater,
supposedly killed himself. But where the rumor began.
Right. Well, that was different. That was different. That was
David Koresh thing was more Janet Reno than that.
Yeah, but
it was under his administration. That's true.
But the guy, I mean, Trump got into office, and that was his next door neighbor, and that's where
his next door
neighbor? And then everyone was saying that he killed himself in jail. Epstein. It was right after Trump got in office, because that would have been bad publicity on his part.
What? Well, he probably had some goods
Trump
on him too.
Wouldn't do anything like, you know, pay a porn star hush money or have somebody in jail.
Oh, he had to pay that. He did that.
He would never do things like that. Like a mobster from New York would do.
Or
it's like a gangster.
No. What was the thing last week that happened?
I don't know.
He was in court for sexual abuse, wasn't it? Was it sexual abuse or sexual allegations?
Sure. No. The Eugene Carroll thing. She sued him again for defamation, and he owes her another $5 million.
It was $6 million.
Is it six?
Yeah, it was $6 million.
Yeah, he lost twice against Eugene Carroll.
Yeah, so
she won the first thing,
and then he said he didn't.
Look, you can't. You were found guilty of sexual assault.
Yeah.
And then after the case,
He goes on TV
and everything.
Says he never knew her.
I never knew her. It's like you were found guilty
in a court of law. So you can't say you didn't know.
He was found guilty.
You were found guilty of.
Yeah, he's found guilty in a court of law, and then he went on television and said that he didn't do it.
Which court of law? Where was this?
In New York.
When was this? Recently?
Yeah, it was like last year,
6 months ago.
Yeah.
No, they didn't convict him on anything.
Yeah, he was found guilty.
He was found guilty, and then he paid a fine.
It was a civil case. It was not. Yeah. He wasn't a criminal case.
Yeah, but in a court of law, he was found
civil.
But it's still court.
The verdict was guilt.
Right.
Yeah, and he knows who she is.
Yeah.
So you don't go on television saying you don't know who she is.
Yes.
But it's so not a guilty verdict of him doing anything sexual to somebody.
Yes, it was.
It was defamation because he was.
The second one was defamation. The first one was sexual assault.
Yeah. And
and he goes right after the sexual assault verdict. He went and said, "I never knew her. She's not my type," and whatever. And she went, "Hey,
you can't say that. We were just in court."
Yeah. So the judge. Now owe her another $6 million.
Yeah.
On top of your original judgment.
Yeah. So it's the dude's in some serious trouble and he wants to run for president. How's that possible? How is that humanly possible?
You have to be somewhat delusional.
I can see what's going on with him. I'm not fooled.
Guy's whacked.
You have to be.
I mean,
I've known people.
He is a good character, and I don't think he should be president, but they're running after him and literally trumping up shit to destroy him.
Well,
I'm not stupid.
I don't think you have to make anything up about
him. Just keeps talking. He just opens his mouth and
the media is right there with a microphone.
It should be because he's a public figure. If you're going to be in charge of someone's of the people,
he's not president. He hasn't been president for 4 years, almost.
Well,
neither is Obama, but or they keep bringing Clinton. Him
on. But
feeling the pain of that.
Speaking of Megyn Kelly, this week went on television saying about people are saying that the Obamas have a shadow puppet government. Shadow puppet.
Shadow. What are you saying?
that's the freaking headline.
It's because he's black, isn't it?
It's because he's black, yes. She was just asking on her, just asking questions on Newsmax.
What they're saying is that he's pulling the strings behind Joe Biden. Like Obama's kind of like going, "Hey Joe, do this.
Come on,
do that."
Well, he's the one who made the phone call on Bloody Tuesday or Bloody Monday or whatever that was. Do you remember that?
Bloody Monday.
Before the primary, he made a phone call. Buttigieg dropped out. Elizabeth Warren stayed in. It's screwed over Bernie.
Yeah, screwed over Bernie.
Oh, wow. I don't know. I don't know. They just want out.
I don't know.
He's want nothing to do with it. His wife wants nothing to do with it. They always say they didn't want anything to do with it.
Parties are garbage.
They are.
I just want Al Sharpton to pay Tawana Brawley what he owes her.
Ah.
But he doesn't.
Will Joe Biden ever face his sexual allegations? With Tara Reid or whatever that...
Tara Reid.
What?
The TV?
Sharknado girl?
Yeah.
I don't know. She's supposed to have sexually assaulted or something.
I don't know.
I'm going to look at
that. No one ever hears about that.
Anyway.
I got to see that. No, because I'm a big Tara Reid fan.
I'm getting the name wrong, probably. So.
Probably. I'm going to...
It is Tara Reid. Biden's sexual assault allegation.
I'm going to jump off the...
You're going to jump off the act?
And we got jump off
and it's not the actress. It's a different spelling.
Oh, okay.
It's not Tara Reid from from Sharknado
and
from all those teen movies. This is Biden would never. Not even with Obama's dick would he do that.
Why would you say he wouldn't do? Why are you making an excuse for him?
No. I'm just not. I'm just looking at her. I said, no, dude. No. No. I don't get no. That's no. Sorry. I'm just looking at it.
Politics aside.
Yeah, seriously.
Time for Soundbytes.
It's actually Dr. Linda.
Oh, yeah.
Dr. Linda here.
It's Pooh Corner with Linda.
Yes.
Today on Pooh Corner, the Medici Mystery. In 2012, archaeologists working in the courtyard of the Palace of Fontainebleau outside of Paris were startled to find Catherine de Medici's hairpin in a very old public toilet. The gold pin was clearly marked with her insignia, though how it could have landed there remains a mystery, with some suspecting that it may have been stolen or dropped by a lady-in-waiting.
Learn something new each week with Dr. Linda in Pooh Corner.
Wow, the Medici mystery, huh?
Yeah, it's a mystery because I don't quite follow what was going on there.
They found her hairpin in a toilet.
Why were they looking there?
They weren't looking. They were just it was archaeologists. They found it in an old toilet.
Well, maybe she lost it.
Sure.
I had my iPhone in my shirt pocket. They didn't have toilets back then, man.
Toilets back then. It was like you're talking the 1600s or 1500s.
Look, when you gotta go, you gotta go.
They would bury it.
You went, damn it! I knew I had that hairpin when I went in there. What happened to it?
Nice.
It's like, you know,
when was Catherine Medici?
Went right down the toilet. Like I had my iPhone in my shirt pocket, and I bent over to flush the toilet, and it fell out. But thankfully, I closed the toilet.
Ah.
And it bounced off the seat. And I was like, wow, you know, save myself.
Good deal.
Now, if Catherine Medici had an iPhone in 1547.
They'd find it in the latrine.
In the latrine?
Yeah.
Or the porta potty at
the outhouse.
At the outhouse.
Yeah.
At the outhouse. At the red man. At the fire. At the fireman. Fire.
Burning Man.
Burning Man. Yeah. I'm telling you, I'm not with it.
Where is your brain?
My brain is not with me.
No, it's Joe Biden.
Oh, no. God.
In his puppet government.
His puppet. No, that's Obama.
With the.
Obama and I don't get these conspiracy theories. None of them make sense. None of them.
I've come to the conclusion that this whole transphobia thing is really just a rehash of the satanic panic in the 80s.
You're right.
The exact same kind of. Oh my goodness. And everybody's freaking out over nothing.
I was listening to a podcast and this podcast, they were talking about the LGBTQ
plus.
And she, and this girl was like, I am not gay. I'm L was the quote.
Lesbian.
Yes. But isn't that gay?
I guess. I don't know.
In the woman's version of gay, I suppose, sure.
But if she's not gay,
I don't know.
What is a lesbian?
I don't argue anymore.
They don't make sense.
Just be whatever you feel like.
Some of these things that people are saying nowadays
not
contradict everything that they all are.
That's because one person contradicts because they all want to be special. They are merry
contraries. That's all they are.
I don't care.
Right, Bob?
I don't care. I really don't.
Aye, aye, aye.
It doesn't change anything about me one bit.
All right. Yeah.
Well, you have a very good attitude.
Yeah.
It doesn't. About that. It doesn't bother me.
Why would it bother us? Or anybody.
Even if you wanted to worship Satan, go right ahead.
Yeah.
Just don't hurt nobody.
Exactly. Don't hurt nobody.
Don't cause harm to somebody else.
Eat some cake and pie.
Sounds It sounds like Bob wants to be alone.
It's not that I want to be alone. It's just, you know, don't bother me. I won't bother you. How yep. about that?
There
we'll
it is.
All just get along.
Right.
And drive a little faster than the speed limit. That's all I ask. 5 miles faster. Just come on.
There was a...
just get stay out of
Are mind. You talking to the Canadians?
This week, you mentioned Ron DeSantis. There was this thing that was
Dick Sant-ass. Get it right.
Diary of Anne Frank was banned from the schools this week.
Oh yeah.
What a Dick yeah. Sant-ass.
Yeah. Sure. Was it?
Does he have a signed copy?
I don't know.
Nice,
a signed copy.
Why would they ban?
I don't know. But
oh, you don't want to go down that rabbit hole. You do not. The Diary of Anne Frank. Oh my goodness.
Why?
There's a lot of conspiracies. Like, oh, it was part of it was written in ballpoint ink. Oh, yeah. It's like in a different color.
In a different color? Kind
of, yeah, don't go. Don't.
How it was. But
there's conspiracy that it was forged by her dad.
Her dad?
Yeah.
But.
Yeah, like I said.
He's creating theater.
You don't want to go down that rabbit hole.
I don't know. But was it Ron DeSantis? He's facing backlash over the quote unquote Stop Woke Act, which compels stupid. School districts to remove books that deal with critical race theory. And because of the content of Anne Frank, that's being banned from libraries as well as schools right now. So
it's important that you learn these things.
Yeah. Otherwise, when it happens again,
because learning
you'll
these
know.
Things makes you human.
Yes.
Caring about other people and what they go through makes you human.
Yes. So, I mean, that's
you're empathetic.
Yes. And that's
you're
a
not
good
pathetic.
Thing to teach people.
You're empathetic. Yes.
Yeah.
You go, man, that must suck to have to, you know, hide in the attic from the Nazis and fear for your life. That had to suck. And we shouldn't have to put anybody through that.
No, ever again.
And we should learn about that.
Yeah, if you don't know about it, how are you going to learn? I think it was on Ralph's show. He's Ralph. Welcome to the show. I think it was on your show that Ali, gentleman from Iran, was on the show, and I was flipping through, and he was explaining how the different laws of you're not allowed to be a homosexual, or they can just kill you because it's against the law.
Yeah.
And so there's various other Shiri.
Sharia law.
Yeah, the one that they said that Hillary Clinton was going to invoke.
Sharia law.
Yeah, which is impossible. But he was explaining that, those kinds of laws that happen in Iran. And it's just what he was explaining, granted, we're not familiar with here in this country. Or on our whole culture, the whole Western civilization, they're not familiar or they understand that that's their belief. And that's what they grew up knowing. And that's that. So, of course, that's what they're going to believe, just like we believe what we do. And
we believe it's wrong and they believe it's right.
Exactly. And vice versa. And so everybody has their own. Yeah.
That's true.
So it just depends on where you are and what we're going to be doing. And we're going to continue it right here with Soundbytes.
Yeah. Well, we're not going to continue that discussion with Soundbytes. I have a completely different theme.
Okay. What is that theme?
Well, what's rule number one of this show?
Don't talk about work.
So this
or politics or.
Well, we talk about politics a lot.
We do. But that was actually one of the original.
But this is all about work.
Okay. Oh, sheesh. We don't talk about work.
So I'm But I can make a playlist about work.
You can make a playlist about work.
Hit the thing there.
And oh, okay. Hold on a second. This one.
Sound.
All right.
Okay. Some of these might be loud. I don't know the levels, so just give me the thumbs up or thumbs down on the.
Okay.
All right.
Here we go.
Here we go. Let's begin it by.
I do know who this is.
All you gotta tell me now is wow, welcome to the working week.
If you know the song, type it in. If you know who did the song, type it in.
Welcome to the working week.
And thanks for joining the show, Ralph.
Pretty much gave you the title.
Well, this is Elvis Costello.
Yes. Welcome to the working week.
Welcome to the
working week. Nobody, and I mean nobody, should get the next one wrong.
Oh, okay. All right. All right, you know the song. Turn it up. And if you know the song, type it in. Let us know. Mama Bear Tracy.
Of course. Wow.
9 to 5.
9 to 5.
And Ralph gets Dolly.
There you go.
Yes.
Right. Bob's carrying on the working theme.
Yes, he is. If you know.
Some people say a man is made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood.
It's an oldie.
Muscle and blood and skin and bones.
Got a few
a
old ones
that's
here.
Weak and a back that's strong. You load 16 tons.
Steve's theme song every morning.
Mama Bear Tracy got 16 tons.
There you go.
Saint Peter, don't you call
this is my theme song.
Every morning you go to work. This must be playing in your mind.
Oh, it will be now. Thank you. Jesus.
You know who it is?
Who is this?
This is Tennessee Ernie Ford.
I just saw him in the news. Wasn't his birthday was not too long ago. It was one of the...
One of the birthdays. Now the next one leads right into it.
All right, what's the next one? Same beat. All right, if you know the song, if you know who did it, whoop, you know it. It's not Devo.
I know. I was going to use the Devo, but I decided to go with all original.
The original ones.
And that was just because of last week's terrible covers.
Mm. Although Devo's version of this was pretty good.
Yeah.
All right, who did this?
This is Lee Dorsey.
Lee Dorsey
working in a coal mine.
Lee Dorsey, right there. Oh my God! This is Mama Bear Tracy's anthem.
Yeah, mine too.
Yes, there you go.
I am born on a Saturday, so the Saturday's child has a lot of work to do.
There you go. You know how old this song is?
My God, 40 years.
Yeah,
40
same
years.
With Dolly Parton.
Yeah.
No one works at 9 o'clock anymore.
It's like we'll give you an hour lunch. It's like, no, you're not. You're taking an hour out of my day.
Two.
Right. Yeah, so Working Man by Rush.
Rush.
And of course that leads into
You know this one, Tony.
Yes. I'm a blue collar man.
There you go.
Blue collar man.
All right. Any takers on who did this song? You can type it in.
I won't say it.
That is Styx, folks. Okay. That's Styx. All right.
Yes.
Now this is going to
ding,
the next
ding,
one.
Ding.
Yes, this next one. If you don't like this next band, there's something wrong with you.
Oh, okay. I know this song.
Oh, I love this band.
Everyone loves this band.
Everybody should love this band.
Even though they did get sued for
why?
The What was that Michael J. Fox movie?
Back to the Future.
Back to the Future.
No, they got sued for, I think one of new drug was rip off of Ghostbusters.
So oh, was that guy? That's right, Ghostbusters. Ghostbusters.
They sued each other. I don't know who sued who.
Huey Lewis in the News is correct.
There you go.
Working for
Working
a living.
For a living.
That's right, you're right, Ghostbusters.
Yeah.
Because they were supposed to do the theme track.
Right.
And they didn't get it, and they got pissed off and did one a new drug.
Yeah.
And that's what that was.
All right, Steve, just for you.
All right. Oh, I can't hear that. What is that?
As soon as you're born, they make you feel small.
Oh, my goodness. Anyone know this one? It goes back to his first solo album.
No time instead of it all. Till the pain is so big, you feel nothing at all.
If you don't already know it, this is by John Lennon. Working man's working class hero.
Working class hero.
That's it.
If you're a working class hero, you can.
Working class hero is something to be.
Take this job and shut.
No,
that's right.
Isn't that the name of the song?
That's it. That's it. That's it. And do you know who did it?
It's Johnny.
Johnny Paycheck. And what I got today. Yes.
Johnny Paycheck.
Isn't that ironic?
Yeah.
That's right.
Also done by Dead Kennedys.
Yeah, but.
Now, if you took this job and shoved it, you need to.
If you know the song, type it in. This is our working sound bites right now. And it is not Sha-na-na.
Get a job.
Get a job.
All right, who did this? Mama Bear Shave. I know, but I can't think of it.
It's the Silhouettes.
The Silhouettes, folks. Now, going back to what, 1958? I'm thinking 1958.
Hang on, maybe I can do a get info. No, I can't. Anyhow, bonus number 11.
Bonus?
Because if you got to get a job, you need to.
Walked all day till my feet were tired. I was low, I just couldn't get hired. Saw a sign in a grocery store. Help is light, and we need some more.
I got a job.
You got one?
I got a job.
Yes, got a job.
Got a job.
Got a job. And I just discovered this, making the playlist. Got a job. This is anybody who doesn't know.
I don't know this one.
This is Smokey Robinson and the Miracles.
Wow, this is the Miracles?
Yes.
Wow.
Got a job. Answering to the get a job.
Wow.
So get a job, got a job. So he said, welcome to the working week, working 9 to 5, 16 tons, working in a coal mine, working man, blue collar man, working for a living, working class hero. Take this job and shove it. Get a job, got a job. There you go.
That was awesome.
Is that all of them?
Can you read that again real quick?
Yes.
Because it was really hard.
We started off by saying, welcome to the working week, working 9 to 5, 16 tons, working in a coal mine, working man, blue collar man, working for a living, working class hero. Take this job and shove it. Get a job. And I got a job.
All right.
There it is, folks.
May I add one? Can
sure.
You guess who? Can you guess who this is?
I know this one.
I love this one.
I was a rebel from the day I left school. Grew my hair long and broke all.
This is great. Goes right along with everything.
Listen to my records all day. With big ambitions when I could play. My parents taught me.
I'm not going to say it. I'm not going to say it.
Mojo Nixon.
It's not Mojo Nixon.
They said my friends were just an unruly mob.
Not Mojo Nixon.
Get a haircut and get a real job. Get a haircut and get a real job.
And don't be a slob.
Get together like your big brother Bob. Get a haircut.
Is this Kentucky Headhunter? No.
Who is it?
It's Thorogood, man.
George Thorogood and the Delaware Destroyers.
Wow. George Thorogood. This just popped up. Police launch investigation into viral video of cop kissing a woman and then joining her in the back seat of his cruiser.
Nice.
Did they film it?
It's a viral video, dude.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Yeah.
Busted.
Busted hard. Wow.
So what, they got in the back of her car or the police
in the cruiser? Police cruiser.
You can't get out if you get in the back of a police cruiser.
I don't know. Maybe no. I don't know. I guess he
did. Did you ever see that video of the hooker going into the back of an Amazon van? That was a good one.
Talk about free delivery.
Yeah.
Oh, speaking of, you have to pay for that now.
Oh, the returns.
Yes, you have to pay for returns on Amazon. I think there's
a limit to it.
I don't know, but folks, that did it for Bob's Soundbytes. A job Soundbytes. He did a great job on that, Bob.
Excellent. Excellent. I liked adding into helping Bob there a little at the end.
That was great. That was great.
Oh,
thank you, Tony.
There was a lot more.
And Ralph's here. Oh, good job. Good picks. Mama Bear's like, good job.
I think blues is out of that struggle or whatever, like pain, whatever you're singing from out of.
Yeah, it's just bitching about your job.
Put it into a blues song or put it into a song you're angry. Let's rock and roll, man.
Yeah. Rome, welcome to the show. You are on the Potluck Podcast. And we just got finished playing Sound Bites with Bob Dammit, and he tonight had songs about the workplace. So there you go.
Can't bitch about work on this show.
I know, right? So we don't normally talk about work.
I played songs bitching about work.
So, yeah. So there it is.
There
it is. Yes. And so it's about that time, folks. We do it every week. So we're going to do it right here, right now. This is fantastic stuff. It's time for Florida Man. Yes.
Ooh, I'm going around the Everglades, going around the Everglades, going around the Everglades, and my friend today. Oh, yeah. We're hanging around on the Everglades on this wind fan
hovercraft. Hey, with the bear. Brand new news, folks. Brand new news.
New news?
New news.
New news.
Yes, brand news. Bob and I are going to be going on a wind fanned hovercraft.
Oh yeah.
As our friend Popsky has sang on our theme song here.
The option of a swamp buggy or the fan boat.
When you're doing it, can you play it when you're doing it?
I'm sure.
When you're out on there.
Yeah, but Bob, you're gonna have to be the bear. Okay. You have to wear your Hershey Bears and you'll be the bear.
Well, oh no, I meant
hopefully you'll cool off by the time we do this.
Oh yeah.
Well, because it's freaking hot. It was 92 degrees today.
Yes, it was.
I was thinking more like the theme, but you probably couldn't hear it with the fan.
Oh yeah.
What do they call those boats? Airboats?
Airboats, yeah. They're airboats. So yeah. So that we'll be going on one of those. It'll be before November. So we're going to be in a couple weeks. So we'll be on
strap that. In and it's real fast.
I always wanted to do one of those airboat things.
So did I. I was supposed to go on one buggy, 2 years ago for my birthday.
Sounds stupid.
Yeah. So, but I guess they have the tall chairs that are on like a pole. I don't know.
Yeah. And you got to strap in.
I don't know. We'll figure it out. We'll figure it out.
You're going to get there and chicken out, man.
No.
Oh, I'm not going to chicken out. I'm just going to bring freaking ear protection.
Yeah, we'll have to put some stuff in there. Okay, so if you've never played Florida Man before, I'm going to give you two headlines. You have to decide whether or not which headline is actually the real headline. Yeah, and that's how it works. And here's the first one. Here we go. Florida man sits on gun, shoots himself in penis.
Ooh. Right in the ding ding.
In the ding ding. Florida woman arrested for setting up fake toll booth on Midtown Bridge.
How?
I don't know. That's so you have to decide which one is the actual headline.
I'll go fake toll booth. Oh, go ahead.
I'm going to go with the gun.
You're going to go with the gun and shoot himself in a ding-ding? Yeah,
fake toll booth, that takes some work, some effort. You know, how do you sneak that?
I don't know. I mean, you get a cardboard box with a cut hole in it.
Yeah,
refrigerator box.
Give me a 50 buck. Cents, a dollar.
Yeah, was it a dollar?
Dollar and a quarter to go over this skyway.
Skyway now?
Shoot, man, how do you think I got through college?
That's nothing. It's like eight bucks to go over the Verrazano Bridge in New York. Like
what?
Their bridge fees are crazy.
That's nuts. No way. Well, all right. So here we go. I'm going to give the drum roll. It looks like everybody's saying number one except for Tone. So, all right. Everyone is correct except for Tony. Sorry, man. It's happened in Jacksonville. A Florida man accidentally shot himself in the penis when he sat down on a gun in the driver's seat of his car. Several television news stations reported that the Jacksonville Sheriff's Office says that the man ran into his girlfriend's house Friday after the gun discharged. She saw that he had a wound in his groin and then took him to the hospital where he underwent surgery. The sheriff's office said that the 38-year-old man had a previous conviction for cocaine possession and now faces charges of a felony in possession of a firearm.
Yeah, that's a Darwin Award right there.
Yeah.
Wow.
What?
You've done the world a service by denying your ability to procreate.
Guess so. All right, here's the next one, folks. Mm-hmm. All right. Florida woman beats boyfriend with dozen roses after he brings her wrong color.
I believe that.
She wanted red.
Yeah.
Florida man. Here's the next one.
I would have done it, too.
Right? Just beat him up?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Florida man tries to shoot puppy, but puppy shoots him instead.
Oh, my.
So which one is it, folks? The Florida woman beating her boyfriend with a dozen roses because she wanted a different color?
But the pink ones were cheaper, baby.
Or the Florida man trying to shoot the puppy, but the puppy shot him instead. Ralph saying number one. Mama Bear saying two. Because she wouldn't hit anybody if they gave her roses, no matter what color they'd be. Isn't that right, Mama?
I don't know what the different colors signify. They mean different things.
She's like, sure.
I once knew a chick who said she wanted blue roses. And I was like, that's not a thing.
It is a thing.
Blue roses, they don't exist.
They do exist.
No, they don't. Yes. There is no such thing as blue roses.
Yes.
But I consider that likely. However, I want to go with the dog.
You want to go with the dog?
I want to.
What about you, Tony?
So freaking ridiculous.
I went with the roses, I guess.
Roses, right? The roses. Okay. So you're with Ralph. Mama Bear says two. With Bob trying to shoot the puppy, but the puppy shoots him instead. And the drum roll, please. It is number two. Florida man tries to shoot the puppy, but the puppy shoots him instead. Deputies in Pensacola, Florida said a man was trying to shoot seven puppies when one of the dogs, a three-month-old puppy, put his paw on the trigger and shot the man in the wrist. The man, a three-named person, which we all know they're crazy, Jerry Allen Bradford, 37 years old, was in the hospital being treated for his injuries. According to the sheriff's report, Bradford said he decided to shoot the puppies, which were shepherd mixes, when he was not able to care or find them a new home. The deputies found three of the seven puppies buried in a shallow grave outside of Bradford's home. The other four have been rescued and are now up for adoption. Investigators have applied for an arrest warrant to charge Bradford with a felony of animal cruelty. Now, ladies and gentlemen, that story was from a while back, And there have been several updates to this story since then. And the famous dog that shot the guy actually passed away. The dog's name was Trigger, and it was the famous dog that shot the original owner before the man could shoot him. He had just recently passed away. The three dogs that were buried, four were taken to the animal control for adoption. Former WEAR-TV reporter Andrew McIntosh, who reported the story, adopted the dog that turned the gun on the man, and animal control actually named the pooch Trigger. And he lived a full life, and full and long life, and he had passed away on Friday after living 14 and a half years in Pensacola. So there you go. All right. And that was
Florida
the story.
Florida dog.
Florida dog. Yes. So there you go. All right. Last one, folks. Let's see what we got here. Bum, 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 bum. Oh, what do I got here? All right. Here we go. What? Florida man hiding from police, hides in refrigerator, suffocates. Here's the next one. Florida man wanted by police, found hiding in a dishwasher. So which one is it, folks?
You can't get out of the dishwasher either.
I don't know. Florida man either hiding from the police in the refrigerator and dies, or Florida man wanted by police, hiding in a dishwasher. So which one? Ralph's like, both sound right.
Yeah.
Ralph's like, number one.
How do you fit?
Mama Bear's one.
How do you fit?
I don't know.
Like, the refrigerator number would have one. Shelves and everything.
You're saying number one? Number one.
Number one.
Number one. Everyone's going number one.
Yeah, I'll go along with the crowd this time.
Mm-hmm. All right, we're going to... Here we go. Is it number one? No. Florida man wanted by police, found hiding in a dishwasher. Yes, a wanted Florida man found hiding in a dishwasher in a South Carolina mobile home park. Man was wanted in Florida, is now in South Carolina jail after leading deputies on a chase and finding an unusual place to hide. In Greenville, South Carolina, a man wanted in Florida is in His name was, oh boy, not just three names. This guy's a four name. Kevin Leroy Scott White. Was first found by Greenville County deputies as he rode his moped around a mobile park. The 47-year-old took off on foot into the woods once he saw the deputies. However, they found him again, this time inside of a dishwasher, which was under the porch of a nearby mobile home. What?
I don't know.
I don't know. How do you... I'm trying to picture this in my
head. I'm guessing it didn't have the racks in it.
I don't know, but it was underneath a mobile home.
During
the arrest,
just
White
running around going, "Hey, there's something." Jump in there.
During the arrest, White was bit twice by a canine, once on his side and once in the back of his head. Ooh. The second bite happened when the canine's handler lost his footing and caused slack on the leash, which allowed the canine to release and engage. Engage. That's right. White was treated number at the one. Local hospital.
That was
the that's right. Number one. Engage. He was treated at a local hospital, and then he's been booked into the Greenville County Detention Center for several charges. Those charges include charged with a failure to stop for a blue light, driving under suspension, failure to register a motor vehicle, which is big time in South Carolina, reckless driving, possession with intent to distribute methamphetamines, and resisting arrest. So...
Drugs are bad.
Yeah. The canine handler in this case has been placed on administrative leave because he slipped. That's yeah. Sad.
It's one of those deliberate accidents.
Yeah, I guess. I don't know.
Speaking of escaped convicts.
Okay.
They got that guy in Pennsylvania.
Which guy?
Oh, I was going to update
guy,
you.
Was like, yeah, oh, okay. Go ahead. Tell us.
It's it, man. Delaware man. Update. The Delaware prisoner escapee has been reapprehended this morning. We're happy to report. Now, hopefully he'll make it back through extradition to Dover by the morning if he doesn't escape again. Wow. So there you go.
Yeah, he was like hiding out in the Pennsylvania woods for like a week.
What?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
And I guess he had
a murderer.
People. Wow. Is he the guy who like climbed the wall to get out of the prison? Like spider walked up the wall.
This is the first I've heard.
I'm not sure.
I don't
know. He's pretty badass for doing it, yeah. I guess.
They were hunting him high and low.
Wow.
And was it today they caught him or yesterday?
I guess Ralph said yes.
Yes, today. Yeah.
Oh, I don't know.
But yeah, he was surrounded by like National Guardsmen
what?
And stuff.
Oh,
yeah.
Today.
Yeah. Mm. Finally got him.
Yeah, that's the first I heard of him.
The thing is, you escape into the Pennsylvania woods.
You don't, you're gone.
You're gone.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you could be just forget about it. It's depends like the same as like West Virginia, too. It's like you go into the woods, you're gone. Yo. Yeah.
For a long
time. Find the Appalachian Trail or something.
Exactly. Yeah. Oh, my gosh. All right, we got 5 minutes left. Let's do this.
What the fuck is that noise?
All right, what's that noise, folks? This is a quick and simple one. All you got to do is name this noise. Here you go.
That's a soda.
Yeah. That's very fuzzy.
Yeah. I'll play it again for you if anyone wants to type it in.
Or is it beer? No, it's
ginger
soda.
Ale. There you go. That's very specific there, Ralph.
Make me a shabbing up soda.
That it's pouring a soda. I'll give it to you. Pop in a glass or whether it's ginger ale or
shabbing up soda.
Shabbing up soda. Shabbing up soda.
It's very effervescent.
There you go.
It's fizzy.
Let's see how old we all are. Here's the next one.
Everybody knows.
What is that? Dialing a phone.
Oh, there it is. Mama Bear Tracy and Tony got that. Wow. There you go. Rotary. Eerie. Yes, there you go. Rotary phone. I will give that to everybody. All right. Bum. Let's see what we got here. Next one. All right. This shouldn't be too bad here. Let me see what we got. I think I got this one already. Well, that one. This one. Here we go. My fingers aren't working. Here it is.
Oh, now I gotta pee.
I know, right?
Oh, he's pooping.
I'm gonna play it again. What is that noise?
What the hell?
What is that?
What is that?
Someone going into the bathroom.
Yeah.
Well, all right. Mama Bear got it. She says it's a water tap. Yeah. And it's like water jug. When you go to the water jug.
Oh, and it bubbles.
That's it. Hell? That's when the bubbles go back up into the plastic thing. You never heard that before? Violent. Yeah, that's just. Yeah, it's a, it does make you want to go to pee, don't it?
The trickle love the dickle.
Oh, my goodness. So there you go, folks. That, my friends, is.
What the fuck is that noise?
That's right. What's that noise? One of our favorites. Oh, we got off on a whole bunch of tangents tonight. We did.
Yes.
Thank you, Tony. Yay. But we did. We talked about a whole bunch of different things tonight. We talked about Burning Man, Megyn Kelly, the Pygmy Teens.
Pygmy Teens. Still doesn't make sense.
It doesn't, but you know they're causing havoc.
Sounds like bullshit to me.
And I complained about my content creators.
Which you are a part of.
But I don't go around saying that I am. That's not my
content creator.
Oh.
Sam, I am.
But I'm good at what I do.
That means you're an influencer too.
I have a national award in this stuff.
You are an influencer. And a content creator.
God. If I'm such an influencer, how come my birthday's not up there with all them TikTokers and those goons on the celebrated
followers?
I don't have 100,000.
100,000.
Well, we used to have that with our website.
That's because there was nobody else to follow.
God, I was way back then. Right. There wasn't anyone else to follow back then. Right. We were the first to do it.
Yep.
Oh. Mm. Oh my goodness. But that's what happens now. Mm-hmm. That's I guess
content creator.
Yeah, but they don't know, they didn't know anything. Tony, I have to tell you, these guys, they went on a cooking show and they didn't know how to crack an egg. Or, the one guy, he didn't know how to open up a can. He was trying to open up a can with a knife. And he's like, how do I do this? And the chef's like, use a can opener, you idiot.
Oh, my God.
What the hell? Exactly. And he's a content creator.
Wow.
There's a reason they're content creators. Because they don't know how to open a can.
They don't know how to do anything.
You're talking about it. He got you to say something. So, hey, maybe there's something to it.
Oh, man.
No, seriously, there is a strong deficit of learning basic life skills.
Yes.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I mean, I agree.
Your helicopter parents take care of everything, or, you know, you simply don't have the parents. There's a strong, deficit of basic life skills. Like, I remember being in high school and learning how to write a check.
Yes.
And
yes.
You'd in 10th grade.
You'd be surprised at how many people don't know how to address an envelope.
Or just write. They no longer teach writing. Like, just signing your name.
Yeah.
They no longer teach that in school.
Yeah, the cursive. I can't do it. My mom can still write like that.
My nephew. You can't, when he signs a birthday card for me, he sends me a birthday card. Mm-hmm. If I didn't know
it was
him, I wouldn't know.
Oh.
They don't teach handwriting anymore. They don't teach, just how to sign your name.
It's okay.
It's going to go back to the Wild West where you just put your X.
It's okay, but people
make your mark.
I've had more than a few people comment on my typing skills.
Well, that's because you slapped down because
I never took typing.
That's
the only way I learned to type was my grandmother had one of those old mechanical clicky clacky typewriters.
This is how Bob types.
One handed.
I hunt and peck.
But no, my grandmother had one of those old 30s mechanical typewriters with the round keys that you press down and the lever would slap it would strike the page. And I learned on that.
Oh, man.
That's how I learned how to type. You had to press the key hard enough to get it to
hit the
ink.
I always remember ASDF, JKL, semicolon.
I don't even know what that means.
That means that's where you put your fingers to start.
I can't. I don't know.
ASDF, JKL, semicolon. And that's where you put your fingers.
Right.
And then you can go anywhere from there. And that's how you.
Okay.
And that's exactly. That's day one of typing class, folks.
Yeah. Somebody tried to
tell me, like,
put your fingers on the home row. Don't you feel the little nubbins on the key? I'm like, I can't feel that at all.
It's on the F and the J.
What?
The F.
Yeah.
As in the letter F and the letter J.
I can't feel that.
Foot joy.
I can't do that. So, you're talking about kids not knowing how to, handwriting. I never learned how to type.
Wow.
People are like, man, you type like an ape. I'm like, yeah, I think like one too.
Onga.
I took typing.
I never took
typing. Yes, so did I.
I learned how to weld.
At the junior high.
So there.
You did know how to weld.
You don't know how to weld.
I don't know how to weld.
That's a life skill. Weld two pieces of metal together. Anyway, we're way over.
We are. Thank you for tuning in tonight. We want to thank every single one of you guys for hanging out with us. Mama Bear, Rome, Ralph, welcome again. You are always welcome to hang out with us. George, Saturday Night Smoke, and iDoc. iDoc was hanging out with us tonight. And we miss Mr. A, but I'm sure he'll be hanging out with us sometime. And thank you for tuning in. Next week, we have a whole bunch of other stuff. And more ass breaking news with Tony, of course, and Dr. Linda. And
I have some song parodies then.
Oh, yes. I've been working on some myself. I'm working on some myself.
Good.
And so, yeah, we'll have to put them all together. And if you call in, we can play Word Race next week. So that will be Word Racing. And there we go. Thank you all for hanging out with us. We'll see you next week.
Yowza. Take care, everyone. This has been another Potluck Podcast. We want to thank everyone who joined us for tonight's show. Make sure to check us out each week for all the games, trivia, fun facts, and happenings going on within our lives as well as yours. This has been an MCG production.